My name is Jenny Wharff, and I work here in Boston for the Bureau of Waste Site Cleanup. I am the Reclamation Soil Coordinator. I assist the regions in whatever capacity I can. For some regions, I review all the soil analytical packages. I also maintain monthly spreadsheets for submittal deadlines and quantities of soil reused. I'm going to give everyone a brief overview of reclamation soil. I'm going to explain why we implemented the policy, the amount of soil reused in the Commonwealth under this policy, some exciting new developments, and I will end with some enforcement action. I'm sure many of you are already familiar with this policy, but for those of us who aren't, I will be providing you with a bit of background information. COM 1501 is the interim policy on the reuse of soil for large reclamation projects. This policy was implemented pursuant to Section 277 of the Fiscal Year 2015 State Budget, which mandated that the Department establish regulations, guidelines, standards, or procedures for determining the suitability of soil used as fill material for the reclamation of quarries, sand pits, and gravel pits. The policy is applicable to locations that will accept 100,000 cubic yards of soil or more. Each of the facilities operates under an Administrative Consent Order, or ACO. You may already be familiar with ACOs from an enforcement standpoint, but in this situation, the ACO functions as a permit for the facility. We currently have 7 approved facilities operating under an ACO in Massachusetts, 3 facilities in the Central Region, 1 in the Northeast, and 3 in the Southeast Region. The ACO issues site-specific approvals to ensure the reuse of large volumes of soil for the reclamation projects poses no significant risk of harm to health, safety, public welfare, or the environment. The ACO is negotiated by regional MassDEP staff with input from appropriate municipal officials. MassDEP will not finalize an ACO until all comments from local officials on project impacts related to noise, dust, odor, and/or trucks have been addressed by the project proponent. The ACO with a MassDEP-approved soil management plan together make up a complete ACO and a complete permit for the facility. The Soil Management Plan, or SMP, will stipulate required sampling frequency and testing. Other items that must be included in an SMP are project overview, purpose and goals, total volume of fill proposed, site description of current conditions, so sensitive receptors and regulatory history, and site soil and groundwater reporting categories, including rationale for those categories. The soil management plan will also include developed soil acceptance criteria for that facility and proposed post-closure use. Why did we implement this policy? Well, this policy provides a mechanism for safely managing soil at quarry reclamation projects. The policy addresses 2 issues. First, it facilitates the filling and reuse of spent or abandoned quarries, sand pits, and gravel pits. These locations are often safety hazards, and their reclamation can provide opportunities for beneficial new uses, including parks or solar arrays. Second, it provides increased in-state options for the reuse of soil excavated from new development projects. In the past, such soil often had to be shipped out of state at substantial cost. I wanted to take a moment to highlight a recently completed reclamation soil project. This is St. Mary's Cemetery in Tewksbury. The facility proponents successfully reused over 800,000 tons of soil to expand the cemetery and provide level land for future use. Other projects are reusing soil to create level land for solar, agricultural uses, and the development of a green village. This chart highlights the quantities of soil used to date at our facilities in blue, and in red you can see the total fill capacity at these facilities. As you can see, roughly 7 million tons of soil are still needed for reuse at these facilities. Over 3 million tons of soil have been reused in the Commonwealth since 2016 under this policy. The majority of the soil was reused in the Central and Northeast regions, and some out-of-state soil was also received. The majority of the soil was generated during construction projects in the Boston and metro areas. An exciting new development that I wanted to talk to you guys about today is that street sweepings may now be reused at COM 15 facilities. The reuse and disposal of street sweepings policy BAW-18-001. This policy was developed by BAW staff with contributions from BWSC staff. This policy supersedes the previous draft policy and establishes pre-approved uses for street sweepings that do not require prior approval from MassDEP. Reclamation soil is now considered a pre-approved use under Section 5.6 of the policy. This policy would allow sweepings to be treated essentially as soil, as long as the sweepings follow the testing procedures established in that facility's specific soil management plan. Sweeping must be screened to remove all debris and solid waste. Removed items must then be disposed of at a solid waste facility. There are other nuances and requirements for street sweepings to be reused at reclamation facilities under this policy. I will not get into them now, but I encourage you to read the policy and understand it for yourself. Unless specifically addressed in the soil management plan, persons who would like to reuse street sweepings at COM 15 facilities must collect at least one soil sample to be analyzed. If street sweepings originated in an urban center road, persons must collect one sample per 100 cubic yards. This policy is very exciting because it creates a way to reuse media that has been difficult to reuse in the past. Now I'd like to get into some situations where facility proponents had identified soil loads coming to the property that were inappropriate for reuse and subsequently rejected those loads of soil. The reasons for these rejections range from pH exceedances of the SAC, laboratory reporting limits exceeding the acceptance criteria, particularly with 1,4 dioxane, or other compounds exceeding the soil acceptance criteria. We've also had situations where soil was improperly characterized. One specific situation was a generator of soil did not analyze the soil for MCP 14 metals, but rather RCRA 8 metals. Enforcement actions. The department has assessed 4 penalties since 2016. These penalties were due to late or missed submittals, failure to visually inspect soil load before acceptance at the facility, failure to collect a QAQC soil sample for an entire quarter, and lastly, a facility proponent attempted to submit a drinking water sample claiming that it was a groundwater sample from the property. Amendments to ACOs. ACO amendments may be initiated by MassDEP as the result of enforcement action or by the facility proponents. An example of an ACO amendment initiated by facility proponents is St. Mary's Cemetery in Tewksbury. This is the recently completed project I showed you earlier. In this situation, facility proponents realized that they were not going to have enough fill needed for level land use. So MassDEP and the facility proponents came together and amended the ACO to allow them to bring in soil for an additional month and ultimately meet their project needs. An example of an ACO amendment initiated by MassDEP was a facility proponent failed to collect the required quarterly soil sample for QAQC testing. This facility proponent also failed to cease accepting loads from a generator who had noted exceedances of the SAC in their soil loads. MassDEP and the facility proponents came together to amend the ACO to require the facility proponents to collect monthly QAQC soil samples. That wraps us up for our reclamation soil overview and discussion. Your contacts for reclamation soil will be myself, Jenny Wharff, in the Boston office. In the Central Regional office, you have Paul Vigian. For Northeast, it's John Fitzgerald. And in the Southeast Regional Office, it's DRD Gerard Martin. The Western Region currently has no facilities. However, if it's sometime in the future they do, your contact person will be Eva Tor. Please, I also encourage you to visit our new website, which will have information on soil transportation, reuse and disposal in the Commonwealth. Not just reclamation soil, but all of the soil information you could want to know. Thank you for joining me today.